calls the bruising presidential campaign, and he calls on the nation to work together to bring historic change to Washington and the country. We're back now with our panel, and I want to start with you, Anna Navarro, to talk about conflicts of interest and Donald Trump. It strikes me when I was sort of thinking of the list today, you've got a recent $25 million lawsuit in a fraud case, not releasing taxes, that's old. You have the Trump Foundation admitting self-dealing, which is using foundation money basically for charitable purposes, for self-dealing. And then you have his children who are going to be managing his business enterprises, from which he can't really divorce himself from, meeting with world leaders. How does that even work? How does that even not create some massive distraction in his administration?
I think it creates a massive political problem, not just for Donald Trump, but also for Republicans. Republicans have honed in on the issue of conflict of interest with Hillary Clinton for years now. It has been something that we have hammered away over and over again, and which I think was very hurtful to Hillary Clinton. There was a blurry lines between the Clinton philanthropic, political, and business worlds, and there was a lot of profit made. Donald Trump has got to face the same exact scrutiny, if not tougher. He is president of the United States. She was secretary of state of the United States and a candidate. And I think Republicans are going to have a lot of egg on their face if they don't investigate it, and they're not as tough with Donald Trump as they were with Hillary Clinton, the candidate. I also think that it's going to be a steady drip, drip, drip that the American public is not going to like. We've already seen it be a steady drip, drip, drip in the last 2 weeks, and he's only been president-elect for the last 2 weeks. You've had Ivanka sit in on a meeting with the prime minister of Japan. You've had Ivanka on the phone when he called when he spoke with the president of Argentina, where there was reportedly an issue about permitting of a Trump building in Argentina. But we've seen the hawking of the Trump Hotel in Washington to foreign delegations.
And that's the thing, is you have so many,
the narrative of drain the swamp.
You have so many people who also, they're looking for an opportunity too. Jeremy, right. and I want to tell you, I don't have much time. I want to get you all in with a comment here. Jeremy, I wonder, Anna says he needs to face the same kind of scrutiny. Will he? Will his supporters be okay with this?
Yeah, it's certainly an important question. I mean, Donald Trump has yet to have to actually answer to this report from the Washington Post regarding the disclosure his foundation made to the IRS. You know, Donald Trump throughout the campaign was posed questions about this and insisted that he followed the letter of the law, and clearly his foundation did not here. And, you know, in the New York Times meeting that he had yesterday, he said that he is going to, that he's already started, in fact, to reduce his involvement in his company and hand it over to his kids. But like Anna pointed out, you know, his kids are still very involved in his transition efforts. They were key advisors in his campaign, and that's going to be perhaps the most difficult part for him to separate himself from, because these are people who are not only his children, but who he relied on for advice and counsel, and who were movers and shakers in his campaign.
Brianna?
Yes.
Yeah, I was going to say, look, it's pretty easy to imagine. Imagine the analogous situation with Hillary Clinton on any of these, Chelsea Clinton being on phone calls.
Sure, exactly.
And it's easy to imagine what we'd be hearing from Jason Chaffetz in particular and from other congressional Republicans. I would just submit that they are not really doing Donald Trump any favors by trying to sweep this under the rug and by not looking at it, because while it is a kind of a drumbeat now, if it is not checked, the odds are reasonably high that down the road there will be a bigger problem than they are seeing today, and they're not doing anything. That's not any favors to him by kind of allowing
really
him to walk down this road.
It's a really interesting point, and I talked to Peter King earlier, and he was backing up Donald Trump, and yet I played him his soundbite about Hillary Clinton from a few months back, where he even said the appearance of a conflict of interest raises questions about her judgment. If there is not a double standard, then this should matter.
Well, and they are in sort of an impossible situation, because short of selling off his business and putting that in a blind trust, and he's not going to do that, they're going to have to sort of create something to shelter him from this, because you're right.
How do they do that if he's talking to his kids all the time?
Well, that's the thing. And in the